Hey guys, so today I decided to do another Valentine's Day tutorial on this look that I'm wearing right now. I decided to do it because this has been like a go-to makeup of mine and I thought it would be perfect for Valentine's Day because it's very soft and feminine and girly and I thought it would just be really appropriate for Valentine's Day. I am recreating another Jaclyn Hill makeup tutorial with all cruelty-free products again because I did that in my winter makeup tutorial a while back, and it actually did pretty good, I think. So, yeah, if you want to see how to get this makeup look right here, then just keep watching. Bye!
So my eyes are already primed, and I'm going to be going into the Tartelette palette again, taking Force of Nature, and I'm going to be taking this on a big fluffy brush and dusting this into my crease back and forth. I am making sure to really, really blend this out because this is the only eyeshadow that I'm going to be using in my crease because we're not going to be using a lot of eye makeup, so we want the eyes to look really blended for what we do have on the eyeshadow portion of the eye. So then we are going to go in with Mooney from the ColourPop and Kathleen Lights palette. And this is a really beautiful satin skin tone shade. If you want to use a matte shade, you can just go in with one of the matte cream shades from the Tartelette palette, but I'm using this and putting it all over the eyelid and then going in with a fluffy brush with no product just to make sure there are no harsh lines from the shimmer and the matte shade, and then mixing the gray and the black shade together, and we are going to be creating a wing with this, and we're going to be going back and forth and creating a really, really soft blended wing liner. This is a lot more forgiving than using like a liquid liner or a gel liner, and it also gives a lot more of a softer look, and then just clean up the edge with a flat brush. This is why we did the eyes first, so that we can do this. You could also use tape if you wanted to. I chose to do it this way. So we're going to clean that up underneath of that wing to sharpen it, and then curling our lashes so our eyelashes can be nice and voluminous for mascara, and then going in with the Covergirl supersizer mascara that I have been using for the past like month and a half now. I absolutely love this mascara, and just coating the lashes with this, and then using the ColourPop no filter foundation stick, we're going to be drawing this on our face and blending it out with a Real Techniques buffing brush. I really like using this brush for this foundation. This is my favorite way to blend out this foundation. I don't like to use a damp beauty blender because I don't find that something that's damp mixes well with that foundation. Then using the ColourPop No Filter Concealer underneath of my eyes, blending it out with a beauty blender. This I prefer to use with a wet beauty blender because it is very matte, and I find if I use a brush with it, it's very, very drying on the under eye area. And then using the NYX Stay Matte Not Flat Powder, pressing this underneath of the eye area and around the sides of the nose. We're pressing this into the skin because if you rub, it'll actually pick up and move around the product rather than keeping it in place. Then taking that same Force of Nature shadow on a pencil brush, we are going to be blending this underneath of that lower lash line just to give a little bit of definition before going in with mascara to coat the bottom lashes. I really like doing this because it makes my eyes look more open and awake, and it just gives a little bit more like depth and dimension to the eyes instead of making your eyes look very small. And then going in with Enlight from the Jaclyn Hill palette to highlight the brow and inner corner. I really like this because it is a very, very good highlighting shade, especially if you are very fair. But if you prefer a more yellow tone, you can go into the one next to it, which is Beam. But I chose to use this one. And then for brows, filling them in with the shade Triple Fudge. This is an eyeshadow from the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. I like to use it on a tiny, tiny little angled brush to fill in my brows because it gives more of a softer brow, and I felt like a softer brow was more appropriate for this look, before setting them with some clear brow gel. This one is the Clear Lash and Brow Gel from e.l.f. I like it just to set the brows because I don't use clear mascara, but it works very well as a brow gel. So just setting them into place so our brows can stay like that all day long, and making sure I get them in the right shape. And then going in with the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Bronzer on a big fluffy brush just to bronze around the cheeks, the forehead, and just making our face look a little bit more healthy, like we're not super washed out. And then blending it down the neck and underneath of the jawline, and I will contour my nose to make it look like a button shape, so I go down the sides and then create a little bit of a heart shape on the tip of my nose. look a little bit more of a button shaped. And then we're going to highlight with Summer and Moonstone from the Anastasia Glow Kit to highlight the cheekbones with a big fan brush and the Cupid's bow. And I will highlight the tip of my nose, but I prefer to use an eyeshadow applicator because I find it's just more precise that way. And then using this blush from Bare Minerals in the shade The One, I'm going to be applying it on the apples of my cheeks and up the cheekbones with a stippling brush to help blend and make it look more natural. It's a really beautiful nude color. And then using Nude Love lipstick from Essence, which is a really beautiful nude creamy pink shade, and then going over it with Melted Latex gloss in the shade Love You Mean It. This is by Too Faced, and mixing those two together to create the perfect pink. And this is it for the makeup. I hope you have a wonderful Valentine's Day, and I will see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!